All right, everybody, now we're gonna switch our mentality to limits, all right? So we were talking about integrating, and now we're gonna focus back on limits, all right? So we're in 8.7, we're gonna talk about L'Hôpital's rule, and we're gonna talk about the first form. So if we were to just kind of review the substitution and some algebra of limits, all right, remember our first goal would be to use substitution here. If we're taking the limit as x is going to 0 of this function, we'd plug 0 in for x. But if we do that, kind of taking a look over here, e to the 0 minus 1 is 1 minus 1, same with the denominator. And so we get this 0 over 0. So that doesn't necessarily work. What do we have to do? Well, in this case, we can make it easier on ourselves because we can factor this numerator, okay? And when we factor that numerator, that's just a difference of two squares, e to the 2x minus 1. So we get e to the x minus 1, e to the x plus 1. So then these guys will cancel out, and we're just left with our limit as x approaches 0 of e to the x plus 1. And now we can use that substitution, and we end up with the limit equaling 2. But if we can't kind of clean it up with algebra first, before we make our substitution, well, what do? Well, that's where L'Hôpital's rule comes into play. So there's a few scenarios that we look for. If we use substitution, okay, and we get a scenario of 0 over 0, infinity over infinity, negative infinity over infinity, positive infinity over negative infinity, or negative infinity over negative infinity. Any of those scenarios will allow us to try L'Hôpital's rule. So what is L'Hôpital's rule? So L'Hôpital says if we have a limit as x is approaching some value c of a function over another function, okay? And when direct substitution produces one of these scenarios, what we're going to do is we're going to take the derivative of the numerator over the derivative of the denominator. This is not the quotient rule, okay? So we're not using the quotient rule here. Make sure you make that note. Highlight whatever you need to do. We are not using that quotient rule. It's simply derivative of the top over the derivative of the bottom, okay? Now there's some scenarios, all right? F and g have to be differentiable on the closed interval from a to b, except at that point c, okay? And g prime of x can't equal 0. So the derivative of our denominator cannot equal 0, all right? Some notes, L'Hôpital's rule, it can be applied multiple times. So if I use it once, and I do direct substitution and I'm back to one of these scenarios, I'll do it again, okay? And it works only for one-sided limits, all right? Meaning we only have one limit, all right? So let's go ahead and jump to our first example here. Okay, so we wanna take the limit as x approaches 0 of cosine of x plus 2x minus 1 over 3x. I always go through direct substitution first because if I can do it, why not? Okay, now if we use substitution, we get 1 plus 0 minus 1 in the numerator and we get 0 in the denominator. So this produces a 0 over 0 situation. So that's a perfect scenario for L'Hôpital. Okay, and you'll just see me note L-hop over on the left. That means I applied L'Hôpital's. Okay, so now we're going to take the derivative of the numerator. So derivative of cosine is negative sine of x. Derivative of 2x is 2, and derivative of negative 1 is 0. The derivative of the denominator is 3. Now, can we use substitution? Well, if I plug 0 in, I am left with 2/3, so it works out. It doesn't produce one of those indeterminate forms, okay? And so the limit is equal to 2/3. Let's go on to the back and try some more examples. Okay, example 3, we are finding the limit as x approaches pi over 2, note from the left side, of 4 tangent of x over 1 plus secant of x. If we use substitution, the tangent of pi over 2 approaching from the left is going to be positive infinity. Secant of pi over 2 approaching from the left is also infinity. So we get 4 times infinity, which is just infinity. 1 plus infinity is still infinity. So now we have an infinity over infinity scenario. So we can go ahead and apply L'Hopital. So I'm noting we're applying L'Hopital. So we're going to take the derivative of 4 tangent of x, and we get 4 secant squared of x. Then we're going to take the derivative of the denominator. So derivative of 1 is 0, plus the derivative of secant x is secant tangent. Okay, now we're just going to clean this up. So we have a secant squared over a secant. So that secant squared is going to go away. And we're simply left with 4 secant over tangent. I'm going to clean this up again and talk about it in terms of sines and cosines. So secant, 4 times the secant is 4 over cosine. Tangent, we can rewrite it as sine over cosine. The cosines will cancel, and we're just going to be left with 4 over sine of x. Now let's try substituting. So when we do our direct substitution, plugging pi over 2 in for x and thinking we're approaching from the left, all right, the sine of pi over 2 is going to approach 1, and we're left with 4 in the numerator, so we get the limit to equal 4. All right, so now let's try this very last example, okay? I want you to give it a shot on your own, example 4. First, try direct substitution, see where that leads you, all right? And then go from there. When you're done, check back. Here's a hint. You might need to use L'Hopital's a couple times. All right, give it a try. Okay, the first scenario where I try substitution, I get an infinity over infinity. So we have to use L'Hopital's, right? So when we take the derivative of the numerator, we get 6x plus 6. The derivative of the denominator is 2 e to the 2x. Don't forget that chain rule. When we go through substituting, we get another scenario of infinity over infinity. So this means I need to apply L'Hopital's again. So this is L'Hopital's number 2, meaning now I'm going to take the derivative of the new numerator, and we get 6, over the derivative of the new denominator, don't forget that chain rule, we get 4 e to the 2x. So now if we try substitution, it works out. We end up with 6 in the numerator over 4 e to the 2 infinity is simply infinity. So 6 over a really, really big number just produces 0. So this limit equals 0. Now, the last part of the notes, I'm not necessarily going to talk about. This is more, if you want to kind of take a look at it on your own time, you can certainly pause the video and get the directions here. But this just kind of proves the case of 0 over 0 and how we can get that to be the derivative, all right, over the derivative. So feel free to dive into that more on your own. And if you have any questions, let me know.